Today we're visiting the Wasatch Plateau, one of Utah's hidden gems. In midsummer, it's an absolute riot of color. You will see vistas that are carpets of green with hues of pink and purple and reds as the different species of wildflowers bloom. One of the most important plants here on the Wasatch Plateau is the lupin. It's in the bean family and has the ability to fix nitrogen. So in these nutrient-poor soils, it's really important. The Colorado columbine is our largest and showiest flower. It forms a really distinctive fruit, and as it curves up, it looks like the hat of a jester. This species is Jacob's ladder, and it's interesting because within the leaf, the leaflets are directly opposite one another and form this really distinctive ladder shape. One of the most showy of the flowers on the Wasatch Plateau is the sticky geranium. When the flowers first emerge, they're this beautiful white color with fine pink veins in the leaves. And as the flower ages, it becomes darker and darker red until towards the end of its life cycle, it's nearly fuchsia. There are a number of wetlands and seeps, and what's really fun about them is that they have a distinctive plant community. And this one in particular, there's an abundance of one of my favorite flowers, elephant head. When you look at it closely, what you see is that it's almost a perfect mimic for an elephant. Keeping up with the animal theme, here alongside the elephant head is the monkey flower. And what's fascinating about this one is that within the corolla of the flower, there are these little red dots. This is one that is best appreciated when you look at the detail of it. This species is one that people who are familiar with plants in Utah will recognize. It's an Indian paintbrush. This is the other species of Indian paintbrush that we find on the Wasatch Plateau. One of the most distinctive flowers of the Wasatch Plateau is the larkspur. It's distinctive for its purple color, but most particularly for the spur that comes off the back of each individual flower. It's poisonous to cattle. One of these beautiful flowers that has a dark side as well. The Scarlet Gilead has these beautiful red flowers that have long fused corollas. But when you actually look at them closely, we have a white inner part of the tube with these beautiful pink dots. And then within the floral tube itself, we have anthers with bright yellow pollen sacs. When I first saw these, I was just overcome the detail of each individual flower. And there are hundreds of them